Just to be close to you, girl. Just for a moment, well, just for an hour. Just to be close to you, girl. Always. Live in love forever, yeah.
Take my hand.
Ooh, we'll be alone, you and me, yeah.
Take my hand.
Girl, we'll live our lives together, yeah. Together.
Ooh, together, yeah.
Together. Just for an hour, just to be close to you, girl. Hey, hey. Ooh, 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 ooh. I've been out there searching so very long, baby. For some folks, it takes a lifetime, sugar, to find in this world a dream come true. Why don't you
take my hand?
Oh, we'll live in love forever, yeah.
Take my hand.
Girl, we'll be alone, you and me.
Take my hand.
Tricked out, visit Auto Sound Factory, where they provide car stereos, car security, custom installation, auto detailing, neon ground glow, custom speaker enclosure, computer design system, and auto accessories. You can visit them at 1234 29th Street, Orlando, Florida, 32805, and the phone number is 407-246-0585. Auto Sound Factory. If you be about your car getting tricked out, visit Auto Sound Factory.
TJWS Radio.
The Orlando Times, your key to the black community, covering topics such as politics, community news, sports, and all those topics that are important to you. Pick up the Orlando Times today at 7-Elevens, Circle K's, racetracks, or you can contact the Orlando Times and get a subscription mailed right to your house. Make sure you keep up with the times at gmail.com. To contact the Orlando Times to send news releases, photos, or ads, keep up with the times at gmail.com. www.orlando-times.com.
The Jimmy Williams is always the best in town.
TJWS Radio Network, featuring Jimmy Drop D. Williams and the Jimmy Williams Show.
News on the music, get down. TJWS Radio, always the best in town. Keep on listening.
The best in news, talk, and music. Only on TJWS Radio.
News, talk, and music, get down. TJWS Radio, always the best in town.
Hey, keep your umbrella with you that time of the year. Let me clear my throat for a minute. I am just so surprised about who I have in the studio today. Man, we got the one and only Mr. ALVIN MOORE in the house running for County Commissioner District 2. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing fabulous, Jimmy. Thank you a lot for having me. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, man. Listen, I hear you're doing a lot of great things out in the community. Let's start out by finding out about who you is, where you're from, what schools you attended. So tell us about yourself, man. Where you from?
Well, I'm originally from right here in Orlando, Florida. My dad was in the Navy, and I was technically born in Guam on a military base. And then we moved to Orlando. I went to Audubon Park Elementary, and then Glen Ridge, and then Winter Park High School. I went on to Howard University and got a bachelor's in business administration, and I got a master's in finance from the University of Central Florida. So I kind of moved around a lot.
I see, Mr. ALVIN MOORE, you're a pretty smart man. So that means only one thing, though, you qualify to represent the position.
I don't consider myself a smart man. I consider myself a hard worker.
Okay.
You know, I'll work until I get it done. And I am usually, I think, I always look at the glass as half full. So I always say anybody can do it. They just got to be willing to put in the work.
Yeah.
So I'm dogmatic. I work.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, I don't give up.
Okay.
I'm a fighter.
Okay.
I got that gene. I'll claim to be a fighter. I won't claim to be the smartest guy. I can get by, but I'll work hard until we get the job done. And we can work together. And I like working together. I like a team building. I like working as a group. I like including people. I like inclusion. I don't like just one-on-one and one person's opinion. You know, a lot of politicians will say, oh, I don't need to take a survey to tell you what the people want. No, I want to hear from the people about what they want. I'm not going to go in and just push it down your throat and tell you what you want.
Yeah, man, you got to touch the people, man, because, you know, that's who you're working for. They need to, and they feel good about it once you do that, you know.
You hit on the nose. I mean, the people, if you look at it, you pay about 60 different types of taxes. You pay a tax on your water, you pay a tax on lights, you pay a tax on your utility bills, you pay a tax on your cable, you pay a tax on your cell phone. All these taxes, you pay about 60 different type of taxes. Now, you don't pay a tax for nothing. You pay a tax because you expect a service out of it.
That's right.
So your service is good roads, good streets, the fireman comes on time, the policeman's kind and courteous and answers your questions. You know, you pay for these things.
Right.
It's no handout because you can't even walk down the street barely and not pay for something. You walk in the store, you're going to pay a tax.
That's exactly
you get
right.
your money, you're going to pay a tax. When you spend your money, you're going to get a tax.
That's
so
right.
You deserve a service out of it.
Okay.
That's how I see it. And you pay my salary.
Yeah.
I mean, in Eatonville, it's voluntary, but when I become a county commissioner, you'll pay me something.
Yeah, man got to still pay his bills, but he can pay his taxes, right?
Yeah, you're right. There you go.
So tell me a little bit about the district that you're running for, man. Tell me about the district.
You know, the biggest thing is the district has changed. You know, the district was one way, and it used to be all out of Apopka, mostly. And then in 2012, they came in and they redistricted it. They said it's going to be Apopka, it's going to be Ocoee, it's going to be Zellwood, Tildenville, and half of Pine Hills. Now, when they put in half of Pine Hills, they changed the demographics. They changed the demographics so much that it's now 50-50. It's almost it's slightly a slight bit more majority white people than it is minority, but it's 49.5% minorities, and you know, then you take the Caucasians, the white people, and then half, some of them are Democrats, some of them are Republicans. So you wind up with a majority of Democrats. Mm-hmm. It's almost 48% Democrats, 28% Republicans, and the rest are independents. Mm-hmm. So that's why there's a first time in history. History. I mean, ever since Orlando was, before Orlando was Mosquito County, mm-hmm. back in the 1800s, there's never been a black person or a person of color or a minority in this seat.
Okay.
So this is the very first time. And this, it came from the redistricting that they did in 2012. They did a good opportunity. See, I read my numbers.
I see that. That's good. You're informing the listeners about what you know about what you're doing. It's awesome because they, I would feel better voting for someone that knows what they're talking about, have the facts in place. So as you're moving forward, man, what are your goals, man? What do you want to change in the community? What you fighting for?
Well, you know, right now, I'm currently the vice mayor of Eatonville. Mm-hmm. And so I'm service-minded. Mm-hmm. You know, my whole mindset is what can I do to better your life? Mm-hmm. You know, I look at my constituents and I don't start thinking about what's in it for me. I don't think about what's in it for the businesses. I don't think about, you know, any special interests. I think, how can I help the person who's paying the taxes, who's in my community? How do I go about making their life a better quality of life? And I've been doing good things in my community for the last 8 years. And my first year on council, I said, well, it's nice to sit up here and make a decision, but I just didn't feel fulfilled. You know, mm-hmm. and I was looking for that fulfillment in the job. I was looking to see, oh, I accomplished something. I did something for somebody. You know, I don't want to just sit up there and just make a decision. So I said, I'm going to do something. Mm-hmm. And my first year, I did a crime symposium in Eatonville. Mm-hmm. I brought in the sheriff. I brought in the my police chief. I brought in the local elected officials. I brought in the pastors. I brought in, you know, some community activists. And we said, what's the problem in Eatonville and how do we fix this? Now, I'm not just telling you about Eatonville because I want to say about my history, but it tells you where my heart is. It tells you what a person did in the past is usually a good indication about what they'll do in the future.
Right, right.
So in Eatonville, we had random shootings. People were just shooting their gun. We had a lot of home invasions where people just breaking in houses and stealing stuff. And so we found out that the youth didn't have enough to do.
Right.
So we went in and we revamped our entire youth recreations department. We got kickball. We got soccer. We got youth football. We got stuff to get the youth off the street.
Get the kids busy.
Yeah.
And then something to do with the energy that they got.
Yeah. Yeah. Idle hands make for...
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Trouble. So we did that. That was my first year. And so every year I pick a new thing. And my second year, after we did something for the youth, we went ahead and we did a scholarship program where we are able to get scholarships for the youth every year. And I wrote the program. I took it to the council. They kind of tweaked it and they sent it back. And I was able to get $6,000. And we give out those to the youth every single year. So my first 2 years was about the youth, mm-hmm. you know. We renovated the youth program, and then we started with the scholarships. And you know, every year I do something. I was able to lower taxes for senior citizens with a program I called the Limited Income Senior Tax Exemption. And then we were able to renovate about 15% of the senior citizens' homes. The county had a program where they help you rehab your home, but I went to the CRA in Eatonville, and I said, let's get $3,500 from the CRA in Eatonville. I got $3,500 for each home, and then I went to the county and said, if we put $3,500 into it, do you think you would move them up on your county home renovation plan? They said, yeah, if you put the money in it, then we'll match it, and we'll get them on that program. And I said, well, that's good, but Duke Energy is also doing weatherizations. So I called Duke Energy. I said, I know you guys are coming out here to do weatherizations in a little while. Do you think you can move up your timetable and kind of do them around the same time we're doing this? They said, no problem. So the senior citizens of my community were able to get, they were able to get their taxes lower, and then the next year they were able to get their homes renovated for senior citizens who are in need. So I was able to do that.
That's awesome.
And then my third year, then, you know, we're running about 4 years, 5 years in now, and then I came down with diabetes, and I'm a diabetic. I lost 75 pounds And I changed my eating habits and my life, and that's a whole other story. But when I got diabetes, I always try to figure out the problems in the community, and people kept coming up to me and saying, don't worry about it, I got diabetes too. Don't worry about it, I got diabetes too. Well, I was in a council meeting, and there's only 20 of us in a room. Six people done told me they got diabetes too. I said, wait a second, that's too many people. That's
too many people. Well, I'm going to tell you something, I have it too.
You see what I'm saying? So there were people coming to me saying they got diabetes. I picked up the phone, I called the American Diabetes Association.